All right, everybody. Probably shorter, like an hour or so. I was thinking I was just going to try drifting, but then I was like, maybe I'll stream. I'm not going to do drifting because it'll just look ugly. I'm going to learn that on my own, and then eventually I'll be so good at it and I'll be able to debut it on stream, but that might be a while. So we're doing a different track, different car. We're going to do the 488 GT3 on Zandvoort. And I was doing this a little bit last night, actually, on my own time, so I at least kind of know the track now. And we'll see how it goes. All assists are off, other than the car not taking damage when I hit walls and, you know, the tires don't wear. But otherwise, no traction control, no ABS, no stability control, all the usual stuff. So here we go. Let's do the video games. All right. So last night I was able to do like a 148 or something like that. So if I can beat that, then cool. I want to warm up the tires a little bit before I start going in hard though. I hit walls on numerous occasions. But I started to get like a decent hang of the course as I wrapped up my session last night. So we're not going full bore right now. Next lap we'll start trying and then I'll start crashing for sure. This corner I always end up spinning out on. And this one over here, I just can't get done properly for some reason. I always feel like I'm just not carrying speed or I end up going too wide. Zandvoort in the Netherlands. I'm sure I'm pronouncing it horrendously, so any of you Dutch people can make fun of me. Feel free. There. I should go down to first when I'm going through that section or not. Hey, there we go, 146, I'll take that. Thank you. time. I think I could break later on that. Is that another improvement? That's another improvement right there. Let's go. Oh no! He's wiped out! Oh shoot. We were doing so well up until that point, and I got cocky. I ruined it, dude. Oh, man. Anyway, welcome, everybody. More driving. Yeah. Let's see. We got Gravity Pegasus, 22 months. Sub with Prime Smile. Fireball, 33,000, 22 months. Wami, 500 bits. Do you think sim driving like this makes a better driver IRL? I mean, I don't know for me personally, but I know that there are people, like I was mentioning earlier on the Minecraft stream, that there's a dude who has only drifted on sim games, and he like competed and won a whole tournament, but he's only drifted on his sim thing like this, hopped in a drift car, amazing. So it must do something. Let's see, you're Matt Dumb, thank you for the 3 months, Speedy Sparkles, and Silver Void with 22 months. All right. Let's see, 144 is pretty good. I think that the actual GT3 car time was like 138 or something like that. Hey Quig, what's up? Yes, I did get the racing sim. It's super cool. Okay, let's redeem ourselves there. I'm also right now I'm downloading the let me check on the progress actually. I'm in the middle of downloading the LA Canyons map right now. Let me see. Can I bring it up? Oh, it is downloaded. Hold on. Resuming. For those of you on YouTube, I thought I could get it to work immediately, but it might require a little bit more time. So we're back to this. Maybe we'll switch to, I was also trying an F40. Oh, I'm going to have to warm up the tires again. Oops. I should have selected tire warmers on. I was trying an F40 here last night. Maybe we can do that next little manual transmission action, you know? Oh yeah, Fezza F40. You like an F40, huh? I wonder why. Thank you. Sorry, I can't. It's pretty difficult to respond to chat while we're actually, you know, doing the driving. But every now and again, when I inevitably crash, I'll try to check things out a little bit. Lost a little bit of time going off there. Yo, fastest yet. Thank you. Dang it! That's why I need to learn to drift. Not that you'd necessarily be able to do it well in this. It's on slicks, I think, so. RIP! Let's see, we had, JD Wakura gifting a sub to Quig. At least we had a 144, not ter- or 143. The best yet. Dang, dude. I can't believe he's messed it up like this. I can't believe he's crashed. Salio Nation, thank you for the 200 bits. Much appreciated. We'll get him next time. I can't let my tires cool too much. We gotta be back at it. I just screwed up that first corner a little bit. It's okay. We got it here. Yes, this wheel has force feedback. It is very strong force feedback. Screwed it up again. Good here, right? Because I'm flat. I'm flat all the way through this chicane. I gotta get my braking point a little bit better here and probably carry speed a bit better through this section. I feel mostly good about that, though. This, I could probably brake a little bit later and carry slightly more speed. This corner, though, I'm definitely not doing properly, and that was a huge overshoot there. I would say this here, this section is probably my worst area where I'm probably losing the most amount of time because I just feel like I'm not able to accelerate until I'm already way out of that corner. Right here, I could probably do better on. I'm not sure, like, if you're supposed to accelerate between those or kind of coast. God dang it! He's just done it again! It's all right, just a elegant 360. And then occasionally, yes, I do that. Not learning from my mistakes. This last part I feel good because as soon as I'm out of this corner, I'm pretty much just able to hold flat all the way to the finish line. So can't really do much better than that. On the curb there a little too much. See, when you're trying to like cut off some time, shave tenths of a second here and there, then you run the risk of things going south on you. Dang it! It felt good going through the first part there. But then I had to go and follow it up that way. With more spins. Man's just can't help spinning. You may wonder why I'm doing worse, right? Compared to when I first started the laps, and that's because I'm trying to like shave little bits here and there and change things up. That's the only way you're able to improve the time. So, that's causing me to do a little bit of crashy poo. He's still in it. He's still in it. Only minor cosmetic damage. It is but a flesh wound. Off-roading, no worry, no worries. Even with a little off-roading, we did a 144. That means we improved in other parts. You idiots! God dang it. Thought I was fine, and then just the tail end right there of that strip went right off-roading. The one. felt good, 142. It. Oh, dang it. Frick! let's try an F40. Switch things up a little bit. It's going to go dark until I switch it up and get back into the track, but that's all good. .142.7. New personal best. Let's go. And definitely an overall lap record forever. And stuff, definitely. All right, this is for you, Feza F40. Let's see. Amber Soup with 200 bits. Are we there yet? I need to use the bathroom to get a snack. Everyone wants McDonald's. No, we're not there. We'll never be there because we're always just refining our driving. We're going on around the track literally forever. There is no destination other than the finish line, which then starts over again. Read of Cringe, 245 bits. Will you ever do open lobbies? I have no idea how you do that in this. Of course, I didn't know that was a thing. So, here we go. All right, it's F40 time. Woo! This is gonna handle slightly not as good as the 488 GT3 car. And so there's a very good chance I'm going to mess things up here. And I don't have the coordination yet to do left foot braking combined with clutch pedal. I'm not that capable. The squeaky brake sound is like the same. Oh, yep, and then we're locking up and going off. Squeaky brakes that don't work quite as well as the 488 GT3. I just figured I might have to do that a lot earlier than on the GT3 car. That they managed to actually translate the different characteristics of these cars into a video game. it's a little much. Off-roading in the F40, not a big deal. Wrong thing there. That was incorrect. I pressed on the brake. That was muscle memory. It's okay. Car can hold third through there, just slowly. And the brakes! God, this thing doesn't have brakes! Jesus, that was from the beyond the 150. I was braking at the 100 in the GT3 car. That is beyond the 150. Doing. It screws me up not having the dead pedal, because it, like, my foot positioning gets all messed up. I'm like resting my foot here under the clutch pedal, but I'm so used to moving my foot to the right to get to the clutch pedal because of the normal resting position, so I end up hitting the brake because I don't have a dead pedal to rest my left foot on so I can move it from left to right.
Thank you.
he stays on the track. Ugly line, but he keeps in it. Let's go. Oh no! He wrecks a historic car. How does he do it? Nice save into Rip. Box camera. I don't know what I don't know the best way to do it. I feel like I would need to have the camera that's on my face cam also capture like the steering wheel and the shifter, because otherwise I would need like three different cameras. So I know I'm like slightly obstructing the pedal box with my torso, but yeah, maybe in the future I can find a way to do it. On the track though. Brakes are so bad. They're so hard to get used to, man. That way I won't. Oh, jeez.
acting up so bad.
Everything's not fine. Everything's definitely not fine. Let's keep going. It's to 360. We're good. It's okay. We're gonna, on the next lap, we're gonna get it. This car really, really likes trail braking, is what I'm realizing here. And that is the way to get it to rotate into the corner. Maybe a little too much. Locking up on that braking there. Maybe just brake lighter, honestly. feel for how it operates, though. Okay, we're shortcutting. Taking a shortcut. No one will care. Jardon Cheeserson is not limited to a single game. Never mind. He's binned again. It was elegant.
It was elegant.
All right, one more. Last lap. I was trying to push more speed through there. That did not work. Oh, rip. I thought I had it. Hey, you know what? Let me order my food. In a moment.
quarters in. Okay, cool.
Okay. Here we go. One more, he says. Famous last words. Perfect, perfect. That's just the way I meant to do it. That was exactly the way that I meant to do it right there. Couldn't have gone any different. Look at those skid marks there. What an amateur. Who goes off on that corner? Not me. I would never. Not me! I would never! Frick! What am I doing? Oh my god. I'm like, surely if I break at the 150, I'll be fine. Nope, just go sliding off the track. Jesus. I don't know, if I turned on ABS, I wonder if I could break at the 150. The thing about it is, there's no feedback on the brake pedal, right? So in a car, if you hit the ABS zone, or if you feel you're locking up, it'll give you feedback there. Here, it's like I don't have any of that, and it makes it quite a bit harder. We have ABS off, so obviously there wouldn't be feedback in the ABS, but you would start to feel, you would start to feel it, and you don't get that here. So that's definitely one downside. Clean lap, at least. I mean, come on. Yeah, one more lap, copium. The issue is that I try to, like, keep trying to marginally improve in sections, and that just causes me to crash more and more and more. tried to hold the drift. Second through there. Probably get me out quicker. No, I'm not overheating the tires. I don't have tire wear turned on. He's gonna do it again. No, he's not. He's not gonna do it again. He's gonna do it again. It's a big NASCAR bank right here. That's all it is. Means I have to go at like 2 miles an hour. Maybe I should just go second through here. Now you have me braking too early, huh? Now that I like went absolutely ridiculously out of my way to brake early, that's too much for you, huh? You slow me down too much? Now the brakes work? Thank you. was clean. I'll take it. I'll take it. Oh. Okay.
We did it. All right.
Awesome.
And yes, I will eventually try drifting on stream. I've been doing it to myself. It's just bad, so I'm not sharing it here because it wouldn't be fun to look at.
I think we'll call it there. I did say it was going to be a shorter, like an hour long session, but at least we had a clean lap. God, the difference in time, though. Like 17 seconds between the two things. I feel like I'm closer to the limit in the GT3 car than I am in this. I'm sure you could take this further, but it's more difficult. Let's see. We've got Tiffle does do it a bit. Not sure if you knew this, but you can install mods for a set of course. So there's 2014 Ford GT model. I'm sure there is. Yeah, I just have to look into it. Midnight GT3 RS with a sub. Nice name. Lighter Dark with 2 months cargo room, Nash Reader 8 months, Aaron Water with a sub, Ball Player with 31 months, very cool racing rig. I have a wheel, but need a lot of practice to get better one track at a time. I just got started. How do you think I feel? Your girl Ravioli with 200 bits. This is giving me art inspiration, and I don't even know anything about cars. Kappa. Anyway, this is cool, and I'm going to go to bed. Have fun, bestie. Thank you. I look forward to car stuff. And let's see. Amber Soup, 200 bits. You know what? I should wrap up the video first. Yeah, thanks for tuning in to Assetto Corsa. I hope you have enjoyed. Hold on, we gotta get thumbnail. Oh, by the way, this is what an F40 looks like, in case you didn't know. At least, you know, from the back. I guess we saw it in the pits, but there you go. Third person view. I think the F40 is the most, like, toy car looking car ever, pretty much. Like, when you think toy race car, the shape of an F40 is, like, what comes to mind, basically. Anyway, let's see. Yeah, that's it. Like and subscribe to Captain Sparkles 2. We'll see if this ends up on a new channel ever at some point. But hit the bell, turn on notifications. And that is where we'll leave it off. All right, see you next time.